Everybody, this is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com. Today, we're going to learn about America's 27th president, William Howard Taft. William Howard Taft was born in Cincinnati, Ohio in 1857. Ever since he was young, William was very overweight, and this led to him having many health problems. Sadly, people also made fun of him for his weight. As a teenager, he believed that women should have the right to vote in elections. This was a very unpopular idea in some parts of America at that time. After he finished school, William attended Yale University. William did well in college and finished second in his class. In 1878, he graduated from Yale and went on to study law at Cincinnati Law School. From then on, William always wanted to serve as a judge on America's highest court, the United States Supreme Court. In 1886, Mr. Taft married a woman named Helen, or Nellie Herron. They had three children together. In 1900, President William McKinley asked Mr. Taft to be a part of a group called the Philippine Commission. The Philippines are a group of islands near Asia that America purchased after the Spanish-American War. Mr. Taft was appointed as governor of the Philippines. In 1904, Mr. Taft returned to America and worked as President Theodore Roosevelt's Secretary of War. Mr. Taft helped to make decisions about America's involvement with other countries. In 1908, Mr. Taft decided to run for president. Even though he was not really interested in doing this, his wife Helen and President Theodore Roosevelt strongly encouraged him to run. Mrs. Taft worked very hard to help her husband get elected. Because President Theodore Roosevelt was so popular with many Americans, and he endorsed Mr. Taft won the election by a large margin. During his presidency, Mr. Taft continued some of the same policies that Theodore Roosevelt had begun, such as stopping big businesses from taking over smaller ones. However, unlike Theodore Roosevelt, President Taft did not want to show the world America's power and might, and believed in being peaceful toward other countries. He began a program called Dollar Diplomacy, and in this program, President Taft gave money to support other countries and began trading agreements with some of them. President Taft also created many new government groups, including the Department of Labor and the Bureau of Mines. President Taft also helped to create the federal income tax. In 1912, Mr. Taft ran for a second term as president, but lost. Eventually, in 1921, his lifelong dream came true, and he was made the Chief Justice of the United States Supreme Court. In 1930, 1 month after he retired from the Supreme Court, William Howard Taft died in Washington, D.C., from high blood pressure and heart disease. He was 72 years old. An interesting fun fact is that William Howard Taft loved baseball. In fact, he began the tradition of the president throwing out the first pitch on baseball's opening day. This is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com, and until next time, go learn your history!